G'day guys, it's Sheldrake from the Arma 2 community, Oztac. This video is pretty much just to give everybody an introduction into editing, and it will be part of a longer series of videos that just focuses on editing in Arma 2, and more broadly Arma, because a lot of the tools that you use in this, with the exception of the 3D editor, can be used in Arma 3 and in other series in the Arma games, generally just because they use similar systems. So what we're going to start off with is the 3D editor. I find that this tool is essentially, it increases the immersion that you can have in a game to, well, no, you know, to no end. So I mainly just use this for a base that players can launch out of if it's a co-op mission, and if it's TVT, then really it has no limits. That being said, with AI. Everybody knows how AI react in Arma games. They can be very difficult to coordinate around objects and just things of the sort. So it's important to have that in mind when you're placing your objects, especially if you know you've got them in mind for AI. For co-op missions where AI will have to compete with the objects in terms of their space. So how to launch the 3D editor? All you have to do is come to the main menu. Don't select single player as you would to get into the regular editor. Instead, just stay on the main menu, and what you're going to do is press Alt E. Now that brings up a menu similar to that of entering the main editor. However, this one has a different purpose. So I'm just going to select UTES for now, for an example. And as you can see, it's brought up a screen pretty similar to the 2D editor. The only things that are different are these two bars on the side. You'll also notice all the options here are very similar, with the exception of a few, to the 2D editor also. So what you're going to have to do to start off with is go to center. Now you just select or double click on the map as you would with the 2D editor. And then you get a drop down box here. I've heard that game logic makes the AI less buggy to the environment around it. However, I can't verify that. In the past, I've just used Blue4, and it's worked, fine as far as I'm concerned. However, this is something new to me also. So you just select Game Logic and OK, and you'll just see that pop up here. That is now your class tree. Now Group, just in a whatever spot, and Center Logic, and that's just OK. So that one's relatively easy. That point there. Now some easy tools to help you navigate around an island or a terrain quickly is if you right click. You get new object, that's the same screen as earlier, or default camera. Now that'll bring you into whatever area you've just selected. I'm looking around with the pressing holding the right mouse button and then just moving around the mouse as such. Now you will see then when I selected the default camera, I'll just zoom out to 2D to explain it again. When I click default camera, I was much quicker that time. That's because UTES is such a small map and it doesn't take very long to load. The buildings were very low textures. And that's pretty much just because the levels of detail haven't quite loaded. Never mind. Okay, so now that we're into this view, we can now look around the environment, using your Q, Z, W, A, S, D keys. That's pretty much the same for a helicopter, essentially. Or jets in Arma 2. So you can press and hold those keys to move around. Shift will make you faster. Control will make you very slow. That can help in making some very fine movements. So we'll just move over to the main airfield right now, where we can just demonstrate this tool. So funny enough, most of the objects aren't in, are not in the unit, as you might usually expect for this sort of, for this tool. Actually they're in vehicle. So if you go into vehicle, you can now see all the objects available to you. I am also running the Ace and Acre mods, so that is why just a few of these extra things are running or are showing up the top. And for most people, it'll just start at air. So what I'll start to go to, and what I use it most for, is objects fortifications. And within here, I've got a number of different options as to what I want. So I'll just start off with a simple concrete wall. And for this one, we might just make a simple vehicle checkpoint. Okay, and as you can see, it's relatively easy. Control C, Control V, copy paste. Yeah, it's the same as pretty much any other tool that you would use out there. Okay, so once you've got these objects placed down, you might have one in a place here you don't want it. So what if I want to rotate this one to get a wall effect down that road? I click and hold shift and simply move the mouse left or right to adjust the angle on that. Okay, so there, Control V again, and there we go. So we can get just basic wall going down that road. And as you can see already, that's much better than what Bohemia had in place. Well, it depends on your taste, of course. So in my opinion, you know, it creates a better defensive position rather than those wire fences. If you want to adjust the height of objects, you can simply click and hold and then use Alt and then mouse up or down to raise or lower them. I'm going to keep that one on ground level though. And, you know, again with most tools that you'll use on PC, if you click and then just use Control and click, you'll select multiple. And then you can just click and hold and select multiple again, you know this stuff. There are a number of bugs, however, with this 3D editor. When you adjust height on an object, it doesn't show up in the 2D editor with the method I use to transfer it to that. So it's just, you know, important to keep in mind that your placements are limited when it comes to that. And that's pretty much about it. I generally just use this tool to make bases and stuff like that. I don't place down markers or units. I generally only place down one unit, and that's just to save it. So all you have to do is place down a unit. So center, blue 4, group, west, and now you can go to unit. Excuse me, there we go. Now you've got a player down, or correction, a unit down. You can now save the game. So just wait for this one to load. It's always the longest on the first time of the day. Okay, so now you've got your unit in. You can now click save and call that whatever you want. Again, it's just important to keep in mind those bugs and understanding the way that the AI works in Arma 2. With roadblocks such as these, the AI will have a tough time getting around them just because it doesn't know how to. My advice will be just to make the needed or necessary items that you need, and then to move on to the 2D editor to lay down the actual mission and its groundwork. So that concludes this stage. In the next part of this video, I'll show you how to transfer this this save file into the 2D editor, and from there, how to make a mission in the 2D editor. Okay, so I'll just switch over to that now. Okay, so for this section of the video, I'm going to show you just what software you'll need in order to convert the 3D mission into a 2D one, and from there, in later videos, I'll show you how to just progress that mission in the sense of developing it, and certain methods you can use to make it a mission. Okay, so what you're going to want to do is just go to your web browser and Google search Arma 2 2D to 3D Converter. Now that's pretty simple. All you're going to have to do is find the Armaholic page, click on that one. Then when that loads, it's pretty easy to see. This is a simple software to convert 3D map mission.sqf into a 2D map mission.sqm. I'm not sure of the science that goes behind those and if you could do it manually, however I just find that this is the easiest method. The software converts only the empty side items for now. So that means you won't have your units transferred over, which is why I only use fortifications. So what you're going to want to do is just go down to your Arma 2 3D to 2D map and download from one of those links. I've already got it, so I'll just go to my file there. So then you open it up, go open 3D map, missions, and then you find it. Okay, so I've already converted mine, so all you have to do from then is go into your mission, and then double click on the mission.sqf, and it'll do its work. So it's already, it already exists there. And easy as that. So that's all for this video. Next time I'll go over the 2D mission editor, and as I said, just some simple methods to use in there, and giving you a general outline of what it can be used for. Okay, cheers.